We have breaking news to start the five. Cape Coral police announcing just moments ago that they have made an arrest of the driver accused of hitting 8-year-old Layla Aiken at her school bus stop, leaving her to die in the road. Good evening. I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush, live at Cape Coral Police Headquarters. This is the arrest that Southwest Florida has been waiting more than 8 weeks to see. A 19-year-old man who police say was on his way to work hit and killed Layla Aiken. They have arrested him. Detectives are speaking with him right now, and he will be booked into the Lee County Jail later today. This is what we know right now. 19-year-old Logan Tyler Hetherington from Cape Coral. Logan Tyler Hetherington has been arrested and charged with vehicular homicide, leaving the scene of a deadly crash, and possession of cannabis. And on that front, I want to bring in Sergeant Kolak with the Cape Coral Police Department. When you mentioned marijuana in the press conference, it made us wonder, is there any reason to believe this man was under the influence when he hit Layla?
Unfortunately, that's unknown due to the fact that we were unable to speak with him that day, so we could not see indicators of impairment. So it's difficult to actually prove that without other circumstances.
But you found marijuana in his truck that same day, correct?
Correct. That and some drug paraphernalia.
What took so long? I don't mean that in any disrespectful way, but a lot of viewers have been wondering, why does this take so long when you had the truck that day and you had a pretty good idea of who was behind the wheel?
Basically, this is a murder investigation due to the fact that there was a fatality with the vehicle and the vehicle left the scene. Therefore, we have to be able to piece everything together to make sure that we know who the driver was, number one, and then number two, what crimes that person actually committed.
So I want our viewers to understand how that works and how it's a painstaking process for your detectives. You get a warrant, for example, for the truck and go through DNA inside the truck?
DNA testing. Both. You have to realize that just because we're saying it was that vehicle, there has to be DNA from the actual victim on the outside of the vehicle, which was able to be shown. You have to go through every single surveillance video to make sure that we can piece together where that person was coming from, where they were going, if they stopped. To actually, you know, provide medical aid, we have to show they actually had the elements to commit those crimes. And then interviewing all the witnesses, that takes an extended period of time also.
Was any witness able to actually put Mr. Hetherington in the truck at the moment it hit Layla?
We have surveillance video that actually shows that.
So the surveillance video, that was key in this case.
On top of several other things, but yes.
Tell me about the surveillance video. What do you see in the videos?
You can actually see Mr. Hetherington get into the vehicle. Then the vehicle actually go all the way through to where the actual crash scene is located, not stop, continue on traveling down the roadway. Also see him at the arrive at his business that he works at and actually look at the vehicle when he gets out.
So he got out, must have realized he hit something. And check the vehicle.
Well, he did get out to look at the vehicle, yes.
Thank you very much, and appreciate your hard work on this case. Sergeant Kolak with the Cape Coral Police Department. Speaking of the suspect's truck that hit and killed Layla Aiken, NBC2's Nestor Montoya is there at the scene where police found that truck the day that she was killed back on March 25th. Nestor?
Right. Well, hours after Layla Aiken was killed, police just confirmed with us that they seized a red Dodge Ram pickup truck, actually right over here outside of ABC Supply. Now, that day we received a photo of this truck as multiple police officers with Cape Coral Police were surrounding this vehicle. We know that that vehicle was towed away at the time and returned. Now, at the time of this investigation, we only knew that it was a red truck that was seized, but police, of course, confirming with us today that that indeed was the truck that was seized. And inside of that truck, they did find drug paraphernalia and drugs as well. And we are working to see if we can find some folks who are actually in this area who might have remembered that day when cops surrounded that truck. And again, this was the same day that Layla Aiken was killed. Just hours after is when that picture was taken as cops surrounded this truck. Peter?
Thank you. One of the many tragedies of this case was that Layla's twin brothers, just 1 year older than her, 9 years old, saw her get hit by the truck. Can you imagine? And since the driver took off, they were left there alone, watching their little sister die. I know that it broke the heart, that fact alone, of Layla's mom, Kathleen Aiken. I spoke with her in an exclusive interview last month, and I asked her, what does she think about the fact, and what will she say, what does she want to say to the man who killed her little girl? Take a listen.
If and when that day comes when police arrest someone, what would you like to say to that driver?
I just wish you had the courage to stay and make it where the children left in that circumstance didn't have to be so afraid. Because in that moment, my 9-year-old boys acted more like adults than you did.
Just a gut punch to hear the mom talk about how her 9-year-old boys acted more like adults than the man who allegedly hit and killed her baby girl. Speaking of the suspect, Logan Hetherington, once again, 19-year-old from Cape Coral. Police say he was headed to work that morning. They arrested him today, a few hours ago, near that workplace. They pulled him over. They got all the evidence they needed to make the arrest, and then they pulled him over and arrested him. I asked the chief if he has admitted to the crime. They said so far he has not. But again, they believe they have all the evidence needed to make this case. And I also asked, you know, if he had stopped, would he be in such big trouble as he is today? Would he be facing these serious felony charges? And they said no. I mean, they can't say for sure. It's possible he was under the influence. They don't have evidence of that. But they said most likely, had he just stopped and tried to do something about the situation, that he probably would not be in nearly as big a trouble as he's facing today. So that is the message for anyone who finds themselves in an unfortunate situation like this, is stop, do the right thing, and most likely your outcome will be better. Because if not, and police catch you, you're facing a long, long time in prison. And that's the case here today. We have a reporter at the bus stop where Layla was hit. Do we have, is Michael Raimondi ready to go? I'm just talking with my producer. Let's go to NBC2's Michael Raimondi at the bus stop in the Northeast Cape where Layla was hit and killed. Michael?
All right, Peter, we're going to take you through this whole process here. So Layla was sitting right next to the stop sign here. We heard Sergeant Kolak talk about that in the press release. She was sitting here with her back turned to the road, and that's when the driver turned off of the street here. His tires actually came off the road into this dirt area here, and that's when he collided with Layla Aiken. So if you look at the memorial right here, you can still see the cross, an American flag, some Easter eggs, a candle, some rocks that were painted. It's a lot smaller than it was before. I know some of the family took some of those other stuffed animals and other things like that. Now, the day that she was killed, her mother told us that her two young boys had to act like adults in this scenario because the driver didn't do that himself. And so her two boys had to take care of their sister, Layla. Now, as we showed you, we have American flag. We have the cross here. She was sitting right at this stop sign. The American flag whipping right now. It is pretty. We have benches here as well. We want to talk about the benches. We've all talked about the benches and the new movement in Cape Coral to put these benches here so kids aren't sitting so close to the road or even on the road. So that's what we're seeing right now here in Cape Coral. We will be trying to talk to some neighbors here. We'll be trying to get you the latest information on Logan and the arrest that Cape Coral police made. For now, we'll send it back to Peter and you guys back at headquarters.
All right, Michael, thank you very much. Just a recap right now, in case you're just joining us at home, Cape Coral police have arrested the man that they believe hit and killed 8-year-old Layla Aiken on March 25th. She was sitting at her school bus stop in the Northeast Cape. His name is Logan Hetherington, 19 years old. They say he was headed to work that morning. This has been the arrest that so many of us have been waiting to see for the past 2 months. And Cape Coral police made it just in the past few hours. Now, we are waiting for a mugshot from Mr. Hetherington. And I want you to know that I have reached out to Layla's mom, Kathleen Aiken. She's been very gracious with me throughout this process, sitting down and talking with me several times. And I want you to know that I have texted her and left her a voicemail. And as soon as I hear back from her with her reaction to this arrest, I will bring that to you as well. Kelly, I'll send it back to you right now.
All right, Peter, thanks for your coverage. And I know that that family certainly has touched your heart. We look forward to their reaction to the news today.